called a quest of self. Any near-death experience can send the human mind reeling into an alternate reality to cope. Or, that's what I was told. Dumbfounded by this monstrosity, I reacted the only way I could think of. Was it. So many questions were running through my head. What just happened? Am I even alive? Did I just get a message from God? And that's about the time I woke up.
A quick look around, I figured that Keith had assumed I was dead, taking me down to his infamous cellar to be dealt with accordingly. It was horrible. The stench alone was enough to make me feel lightheaded. Every rumor I'd ever heard about this place was staring back at me with little concern over my fear of it, cheering me. Now, I'd had some experience with dead bodies before.
Oh, God.
But a man has to know his own limits. And I was starting to get fed up. The filth was clouding my mind, fueling my silent rage. I had to end this insanity. Trying to steer clear of that nightmare field, I started recalling some of the intel I'd collected back at D-Town.
It's been told that he devours the flesh of his victims, favoring the brain, under the belief that it gives him superhuman power.
I ain't one to lay judgment, but the guy's a few cars short of a runaway train, you know what I'm saying?
Nothing but terrible things come out of that place, Jack. Just forget about it now.
Nothing I could even use bothered to present itself. If I wanted to survive this, it looked like I was going to have to wing it. Speak of the devil. And thank Mary for sick minds without tidy thoughts. The time had come. I slinked as the angel of death with my heart racing through a shot of adrenaline. One swing to the neck would be my only chance.